Hi, welcome to Harmony with Su-Lynn. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to make your animated scene cinematic by using blur nodes, and I'll animate the blurring effects to simulate a focus pull. So let's start. The assets you'll need is a scene that is set up in a multiplane with a camera that tracks forward or back. You can check out my tutorials on multiplane and camera for more details. I have my scene with a foreground, midground, and background separated out in Z depth. Go to the perspective view to take a look, hold Option and Command and rotate. When you're working with the blur node, you'll need to go to the render view to see the effects on the selected frames. The render view does not allow you to play animation, so you'll need to render the movie to see it in action. First of all, play your movie so you can see where you may want to add your blur effects. I'm going to start with my foreground layer, where I have a character having a drink in the bar. We can go down to the timeline and see whereabouts we would like the blur to be applied. Once we know, we can apply the blur node. You can take a look at it in the node library, put the first two letters, and then you'll see the whole selection of blurs. We're going to start with the blur radial, but I'm going to use the shortcut, enter, and type in blur, and then select the blur radial. The blur radial effect creates an effect that softens the image evenly in all directions, usually blurry due to perspective, or when you pull focus from the foreground to the background, as in my example. Over here you can see I've attached the blur under the comp because I have two parts to my character, but you may attach it directly under your drawing. We can open up the properties and take a look, and we can see that we can change radius. We can also look at the quality and also invert matte. We can select the blur and then go to O to go to the node in the timeline, and then open up the properties by clicking on the plus sign. And here we can see that we can keyframe the radius. So in my scene, I'm going to set a keyframe at frame 32. And keep the radius at 0. I can move my playhead now to frame 130 and add another keyframe. And this time I'm going to put the value of the radius to 5. I'm going to go to the render view to have a look at what that looks like, and I can see that I have the blur effect. I can then set motion keyframes or go to Command K. So I won't be able to see the animation play in the render view, but I can click through and see how the stages of blurriness go from nothing to full blurriness. If I want to see it animated, I can render it out, but this may take a little while, and then take a look. And there we have the first blur effect, which is the blur radial. I'm going to disable my wipe for now so I can see my next character, which is the midground character. I've got two parts to my midground drawings. I have the table and I have a man. So I'm going to put both of those into one composite and then connect that to the main composite. And this is a great way just to limit the amount of connections you have and to keep everything tidy. It also means that we can affect two parts of our drawing with one blur. The next blur that I want to demonstrate is the Blur-Gaussian. The Blur-Gaussian effect is similar to the blur radial. The difference between this and the blur radial is that it does take some rendering time. So this effect is useful when rendering time is less important and quality is more important. So I'm going to attach my Blur-Gaussian under the composite for the midground character. Go to O to take me to that node. Open up the properties by hitting the plus sign. So with this character, at frame 1, I want to set the blurriness at 3. I can have a look at the effect in my render view. And now I'm going to take the playhead to frame 130, which is when my foreground character becomes out of focus. I'm going to make that blurriness value 0, so the midground character is in focus. I'm going to go further and take my playhead to frame 165, and this time I want the difference and the contrast between the background character and the midground character. So I'm going to take the value up to 3. I'm going to set motion keyframes to see the effect, and now if I render, I'll see the effect of pulling focus. And now I'm going to go to my background character of the barman and put in a blur radial zoom effect. The Blur-Radial-Zoom effect creates blurs around a center point, simulating the look of a zooming or rotating camera. This effect is dynamic, but can take some rendering time. Once the Blur-Radial-Zoom is connected to the drawing, I need to display the point of origin, and I can go to Show Controls, the orange railway track, to show the pivot point. You'll need to be selected on the Transform tool to move the pivot point to the place you want the point of origin to start. Once you've placed it, you can have a look at where you may want the effect to begin. If I select on my Blur Radial Zoom node and go to O, I can go to the timeline and have a look at the properties. I can also see the properties here in the properties box. I'm going to use a preset. You can choose whichever one you like the look of. So make a keyframe and then choose a preset. You can test out all the different types. So I have started my Blur Radial Zoom at frame 90. I'm going to change the blurriness value. So I like to do that in the timeline. I'm going to put it to 30 and then have a look at it in my render view. So we can see the effects of the blurriness here, but we can't see how that's going to look in the animation yet. Now I'm going to move my playhead to 160, frame 160, add another keyframe, and then adjust my blurriness level to 0. So there will be no blurriness and the character will be in focus. I can set my motion keyframes. You can also change the fall off values. A fall off rate of 0 causes the blur to fade out slowly, distributing the blur evenly from edge to edge. A fall off rate of 1 causes the blur to fade out quickly, so the blur is heaviest closest to the edge of the image. You'll have to see the effect by rendering out the movie. You can change the point of origin at the beginning and at the end. If you want to delay the visibility, you can add a transparency node under the Blur Radial Zoom. Select the node and go to the timeline, hit the plus sign. So I'm going to delay the visibility of the barman, and at frame 30, I'm going to put a value of 100, and you can keyframe this. I can move my playhead to frame 80 and change that value to 0, which means that the character will be visible, and then set motion keyframes. The last blur I'm going to show you is the blur variable. For this, you'll need to create a mat. You can control two blurs with one node. You can use the blur variable effect to create a radial blur that varies within a single image based on the white and black values in the mat you supply. For this, I'm going to create a comp to include both my pieces for the background bar. I'm going to select on the comp and add the blur variable. You need to create the mat, and if I go to my drawing, you can see that my mat is a simple shape, which is identical to the shape where the bottles are in my bar. I'm going to attach the connector from my mat to the blur variable mat port, the cutter port. When I do that, you can see that I can see my mat. If you find that distracting, you can put a visibility node under the mat port, open up properties, and uncheck display in OpenGL view. Let's open up the properties and take a look. So the black radius is transparent, therefore there's no image, and this is the area outside of my mat. The white radius is opaque, and it's where the image is, or my mat. So let's move the playhead to frame 1 and put values in for our black and white radius. On frame 1, I'm going to put my black radius as 2, and my white radius at 10. So I want it to be blurred at the start, and then as the camera tracks forward at around frame 110, I'm going to put in another keyframe and change those values. So this time I'm going to change the value to the black radius, a value of 1, and the white radius to 0. And you can take a look in your render view to see how that looks when you add set motion keyframes. We're also going to add a glow effect to the bar scene where the bottles are. So I'm going to select on my drawing for the bottles, add a glow node. I'm going to open up the properties and select use source color. Over in the timeline, I can go to my glow node and open up the properties. At frame 1, I'm going to set the radius for feathered falloff at 5 and adjust the intensity to 1. At frame 110, I'm going to change my radius so it's less of a blur and increase the intensity to 1.5. So it will become brighter as the camera tracks in. So at frame 180, I'm going to take the radius to 0 and really pump up the intensity to 4. So as the camera tracks forward, the light becomes brighter. And we can render out the movie to see the results. And that's it for my tutorial on blurs, and we've covered the blur radial, the blur Gaussian, the blur radial zoom, and the blur variable, and I added a glow node as well. In my next tutorial, we'll cover shading and look at applying highlight and tone. See you next time.